The goal of this research is to develop now an interface for people who cannot control robots, but who need robots to help them in their daily life, to be able to control them through their brain. So we are really trying to put together robotics and machine learning, or artificial intelligence. And so we use the brain decoding to tell us when the robot is doing something good or something wrong. So the person does not have to use his or her member to move the robot. Imagine someone handicapped who cannot move the robot but would like the robotic arm to fetch things for him or her.
The most challenging thing was to make the link between the brain activity and the actions of the robot. And for doing that, we have developed a machine learning system that uses artificial intelligence in order to translate what the human considers as error to what would be the most preferable actions for the robot.
In a particular context here, we are learning to avoid better obstacles. There are two ways in which you can avoid obstacles. Either you come close to them, right? You just slide past the obstacle because you're in a hurry, or you try to keep really away from obstacle. This is your user preference. We decided to use this because this is a very subtle information which you cannot transcribe. You know, the too close, too far is not something that has a mathematical value. So we wanted a robot to be able to infer that automatically from just the brain saying, I don't like it.
If someone perceives that the robot would hit the glass, there would be some specific brain activity. We have a system that understands this specific brain activity. So it says the robot, don't move close to the glass, move away from the glass. And in this moment, the robot adapts its trajectory to avoid the glass.
The brain signals are quite noisy, so right now the training sessions are a bit long, so from 1 to 3 hours, but overall all the subjects were very comfortable and they were interested in our experiment.
So for now, of course, it's a prototype, but the long-term goal is to allow people who are fully handicapped, who cannot move their arms, typically people who may have lost control through the spinal cord of the upper body or the lower body, to be able to transfer that to either a wheelchair or to a robotic arm that is supporting them.